Morning. This is Arnie Waters here at Waters Capital in Boston, Massachusetts. Hope you're having a terrific day and have planned a wonderful weekend. Gold trading around 1715, 1714, that kind of level. You'll recall it yesterday we encouraged you to add to your positions by 5 or 10%. We're sticking to that view. Two reasons for this. One, there will be inflation. Don't be deceived by the inflation control number put out by the Fed. There will be inflation because money will be printed left and right, and when the president wins, or if the president wins and there is a public works program, money will be printed left and right, and there's no reality to back up that money. I'm not saying that's a bad idea. I'm just telling you inflation is going to come and that gold is going to soar. Indeed, we're sticking to our projection of gold 2450. What's critical in here, and if you don't, not aware of Jim Wyckoff at Kitco, you really need to take a look at his technical analysis, is that our gold is trading with solid support around 1632 and a range to 1749 where the next resistance level is. And it's important to understand those two terms, support, where the charts show that that gold will not go below this level, and the charts are showing that gold is not likely to exceed 1749. We also want to talk a little bit more today about the dangers of expropriation and the like. The fact of the matter is, not only in South Africa, but also in Venezuela, outright expropriation has become authorized government policy. The reason for this, I'm not going to go into Venezuela. The reason for this in sub-Saharan Africa, and particularly in the RSA, is the RSA is failing on delivering anything of real value except the vote to its constituents. The South African system remains a perverted autocracy ruled by a small number of families. And those families now, of course, are black families as well as white families. And the effect is that the life of the average South African has technically changed because many people are now free. The government in South Africa has already begun to suppress freedom of the press and freedom of speech. This, of course, is the second or third step down the slope, the slippery slope that leads to dictatorship. Now, the reason this is important, both in South Africa and in Mali and some other countries that are resource-rich, is that it affects the supply of precious metals and other kinds of metals and minerals as well. So that's why this is important. And if you're wondering why this is significant in this context, it's because the three things going on, the Europeans printing money left and right, or whatever they call money over there these days, the U.S. Federal Reserve committed to a monetary policy that is inflationary in nature. And once the genie gets out of the bottle, you can't put it back in. And lastly, the change in the political atmosphere, whereas governments are now thinking about expropriation and nationalization of existing. And of course, they wouldn't want to nationalize mines that were unsuccessful, so they're going to nationalize the biggest mines. So this is why in South Africa, to fight this pressure that's coming from the regular people, the South African Mining Authority is really jamming up companies in terms of safety inspections. Now, I'm for safety and against sin. You know, Texans used to say for water and against sin. Well, I'm for safety and against sin. But when companies are being forced to close for months at a time and losing hundreds of thousands of ounces of platinum and gold and the like, it indicates to me the government policy has more to it than simple safety. Are they trying to make it really inconvenient for non-country-based operations to exist in their country? That's just a question. Lastly, I put out a tweet about this yesterday. I look at Zuma as a former head of the secret police for the ANC. I look at Putin as a KGB head. I look at Chavez, who, of course, has run his own state security apparatus and has been a hotbed of Iranian influence as well in South America, as all of them as of a piece. Their core philosophical belief is not democracy in the Western sense. Their core philosophical belief is a Stalinist form of communism where the state controls the means of production. Now, again, I'm not saying that there's going to be a communist takeover in South Africa tomorrow or the next day, but I don't need a weatherman to tell me which way the wind is blowing. So we need to be alert to these international factors as they affect our investment approach. This is Arnie Waters. Aim for the ice flows, not the open water. Have a super duper weekend. Thanks for watching.